back to Delivering Happiness here at South by Southwest. Super excited to be joined by Factory Joe, but no more.
No more.
Yeah.
No more.
Chris Messina, thanks so much for joining us. Yeah, I really appreciate it here at South by. First off, can you kind of explain what you do with your everyday?
Yeah, so I've got this kind of crazy job. I work for Google, and I'm in the developer relations group. My title there is Open Web Advocate. It means a lot of different things. On the one hand, I do a lot of work on the social web, and I'm trying to really advance interoperability and make it possible for people to have more choice in terms of how they use the social web and benefit from it. On the other hand, I'm trying to work internally to sort of evangelize a lot of the ideas that I've been working on for the last several years and let people know kind of inside the company what's been going on and get them up to speed on a lot of stuff that I think is very important for the future of the web.
So obviously it's a little bit of evangelism, a little bit of mix of like thought leadership and everything else. Very cool.
And it's, I think part of it is also telling stories to help people sort of understand where this stuff is grounded and where it's coming from. A lot of it is really, first of all, benefiting greatly from the web itself as an individual. I grew up in New Hampshire, small sort of suburban area, and being able to reach the people that I've reached and also reach out to and interact with all the folks that I have, I think is in a lot of ways because of the web and because of the technology that exists out there. So it's really, being part of that and then wanting to allow other people to sort of have that experience as well. I've been super excited about all the great sort of like design innovation that's going on and all the great things that the culture of the social web is starting to eke out into more and more environments. I think it's, it's attracting a different type of individual than we've had in the past, which means that the way that we design solutions and talk about them also has to change and evolve. And as long as it's making it more accessible to a wider diversity of people, then I think we're heading in the right direction. So for me, it's like looking at all the different stuff that's going on in terms of the startups that are coming out, in terms of the new designs that are happening, and the way that all this stuff that we sort of take for granted, growing up with like IRC and chat and all that stuff, is now starting to make its way into a much wider audience. There's just a broader set of people that are actually getting online, using the web, that have profiles online, and it's starting to change the expectations of what technology should do and how it should do it. So the fact that they're just, it's no longer just for nerds, and there's this great constituency out there that's benefiting from this stuff, means that things like Beluga and things like GroupMe and all these like group text messaging apps are starting to demonstrate not only the power of simplicity and of communication, but of the need to make these tools accessible and cross-platform. Happiness is generated a lot more from the connections that we have with people and finding meaningful work and stuff that we can actually share and do with other people. So in so much as technology allows us to have those channels to connect with other people, then I think it's driving that kind of happiness. We're going through a rapid explosion of all sorts of different apps that are out there, and it's getting to the point where you might be like a GroupMe user, or someone might be like Hashable, and then someone else is Beluga, and so, and on and on and on. Eventually, we're going to have to start seeing some consolidation so that I'm connecting to other people based on who they are and based on how I know them, as opposed to the apps that they use. Like, I am not the apps that I use, and I shouldn't be defined by those things. And so I think in the future, really, we should be, enabling personal APIs so that it's not about the apps, but it's about how we can actually exchange information and ideas and communicate.